this seat occupied by any chance?
No.
Great. Great. Student IC?
What?
Student, I bet. You look like a student. Always tell a student.
No.
Ah. You look like one. You're young enough to be a student, quite young enough. That's life, eh? Being a student. Not a care in the world. Sitting in the park on a day like this, in the sunshine. Rare enough we should see the sun, eh? Rare.
Yeah.
Mind you, I shouldn't be here, really. I should be at home. Got plenty of things I should be doing. The kitchen shelf's the name but three. And you sit at home on a day like today, Sunday. You've got nothing to do and you think to yourself, this is no good, this won't get things done. And there you are talking to yourself. You know what they say about people who talk to themselves, eh? Hey? Yes. So I thought, it's that loss for you, else I'll come and take you away. Mind you, I'm never at a loss. I'm a very fulfilled person. I have, for example, one of the biggest collections of cigarette cards, whether or not alive or dead, that I know of. And you don't get that by sitting on your behind all day. I'll let you into a secret. Do you know what it is that's the most valuable thing that you can ever hope to collect? People. I'm a collector of people. And the best of them, I'm saying this to you quite frankly and openly, the best of them are women. A woman is one of nature's listeners. If I had the choice, I'd be a woman. Trouble is, I don't get to meet as many women as I'd like to. My particular line of work does not bring me into contact with them as much as I would wish. Which is a pity.
Okay,
just
take care of your money, child.
No.
Thanks. Sorry, the man over there won't stop talking. I want to read this in peace. I couldn't concentrate. Just going on and on about collections or something. When you normally don't mind, well, too much. And if you get a letter like this, you need all your concentration. Can't have people talking in your ear, especially when you're trying to decipher writing like this. He must have been stoned out of his mind when he wrote it. It wouldn't be unusual. Look at it. He wants me to come back to his son, hopes. To him? See, look, he's sorry. He didn't mean to do what he did. He won't do it again, I promise, etc, etc. Well, I think you've heard that before. And it's not the first time, I can tell you. And there's no excuse for it, is there, Violet? I mean, what am I supposed to do? Keep going back to that. Every time he loses his temper, he... A fracture, you know, it's nearly a compound fracture right there. Practically see it to this day. Two x-rays. Well, I said to him when I got home, I said, you bastard, do you know what they did to my head? Stan said away, I'm sorry, he said. I meant, sorry. Well, I told him, I said, you bastard. That's what you are. A right uncontrolled, violent, bad tempered bastard. And do you know what he said? He says, you call me a bastard again and I'll smash your stupid faces. That's what he says. I mean, you can't have a civilised, rational discussion with a man like that, can you? Sometimes I just want to jump into the deep hole and forget it. Only I know that that bastard won't come at the bottom. Wait to thump the life out of me, eh?
Yes, excuse me.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to embarrass you. No. I just had to...
Quite right. Excuse me, is anybody here?
What?
Anybody here?
Anybody where?
Sitting here.
Oh no.
Sorry, mind if I do. I won't disturb you. Girl over there, that's got boyfriend trouble. Comes and pulls through out of me as if I'm interested. We've all been through it at one time or another, haven't we? We've all got problems, no doubt. You don't sit on a bench and pull someone's stranger to death. That, in my book, is S for selfishness. And have you noticed invariably the young? They think we haven't all been through it. Don't know where they think we all came from. I mean, 5 years ago, I had a charming wife, two good children, and a house in the country. Couldn't imagine a happier family. Then suddenly my wife dies, my children decide they can't stand a better moment longer, and then we're going to Canada. So there I am, in a black and bearish from your cabin. We don't hear me complaining, do you? I don't know if you're interested, but I'll think about it.
Excuse me.
Hey.
Excuse me, nice little man over there informs me. I mean, it's terrible. Can't fit in the park these days without some man, you know. I want a fixed income. Don't need all that. That comes from my husband, my ex-husband. Runs a pub in the country. Had to leave him. It was either that or, you know. I went want a dog to see, but he would never, ever refuse. Point blank, never could I get a dog. So I had to get a dog. He's usually here with me. He's at the vet's getting his, you know, poor little thing. I mean, wonderful thing about dogs is, once you've got a little dog, you meet other people with dogs. Have you got a dog then, Charles?
No, I haven't.
Excuse me. Excuse me, just take a refuge in that case over there. Maybe we're a pet or a dog or something. I don't know. Ought to be locked up. She'd have to pay him, really. Any man, she wants it. Anyway, I came here to get away from the noise. You got kids, then take my advice. Do not get married. Sunday morning's right, it's a race so you can get out of house first. Loser keeps the baby. Well, this morning I made out first, and here I am in the quiet, like Mum used to say. Close your eyes.
Hey, I've got Ryle on here. Thinks you can hear God breathing.
Oh, are we talking again to me? What do you do?
To the boyfriend saga.
Talk to me one more time. I'm calling the police.
Oh, why does she go home? I'll go rabbiting on. All right then, don't. Fine. Might as well taunt yourself.
Take this pain in mind.
sure that was where you spilled your red wine.
This is where I dropped my beetroot.
Well, if that is where you dropped your beetroot and that is where I spilled my red wine, it's got to be our table.
Oh, I don't know.
Mandy, look, there's where one of them spilled his soup and there's where the other had the accident with his coffee. It's got to be our table.
What do you mean? Where are they?
Surely you don't need me to tell you that.
They look on where we've just been.
Are you sure?
It's natural, isn't it, after all that wine?
See them?
I should hope not.
Well, it's raining outside. Where else do you think they went?
I don't know.
Well, if you can't make a sensible suggestion, then at least sit down and stop asking silly questions.
Mummy, Mummy, I'm bored. I want to watch a video.
You might get one of the other, all right?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the flight. We would like to inform you that today's programme will be 5 Worst Airplane Crashes. If you look closely, you will be able to see our very own pilot featured in the programme. Thank you. To be sick, please don't be sick on any of the chairs or down the aisles. Thank you.
What's that bad headlights? Sound you're really serious?
Oh, the captain's asleep.
What do you mean he's asleep?
Taking 40 wing.
Who's flying the plane then?
No one. We were supposed to have it on autopilot.
Did she just say the captain was asleep?
Yes!
Did I just hear right?
Yes!
We may be serving refreshments, but I very much doubt it. Thank you. The exits are here, here, and here.
Thank you.
Unfortunately, they are blocked. Thank you.
What? Well, we don't have a cargo hold, so where do you expect us to put your luggage?
It's all your fault.
Yeah, you, the kid at the end. Children are always a bad sign on aeroplanes.
Anyone for a refreshment?
Yes, why not?
Oh, sorry, we're out of alcohol.
Excuse me, where's the hot food coming? I've been on this flight for over 6 hours and I haven't had anything to eat.
Look, I just don't do hot food.
What?
Here, have a loaf of bread.
I don't want a loaf of bread.
Can I have a knife, please?
Sandwich.
Excuse me?
Rude.
And Mummy, need to go to the toilet.
Excuse me, would you be able to take my child to the toilet?
No, you can't go to the bloody toilet!
All toilets and facilities are now out of use due to the fact that we have to clean them and we can't be bothered. Thank you.
I can't undo my seatbelt.
That's not my problem.
Well, how am I supposed to get out?
You don't.
I can't undo my seatbelt. Oh my God, I can't breathe!
Open the bloody window!
Can't you give her a paper bag or something?
No.
All seatbelts are now secured for our convenience. Thank you.
How many parachutes are you going to need?
20.
I've already got 2 anyway.
Well, we've got these parachutes, haven't
we? Feet!
Can't you at least leave one for my child, please?
Sorry, I've only got 2.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us on this flight. The airline that's so cheap, we couldn't afford to name it. We've just discovered that there's a hole in the engine and we are rapidly losing fuel and altitude. The pilot has just been sucked out of the cockpit. You will be pleased to know that we are currently plummeting towards our destination and should arrive in approximately 30 seconds. Thank you.
Flower.
Don't use that bloody language at me, son, or I'll spank you.
24.
24. Stew without a wine.
sorry, Grandma, I didn't mean it.
Not that long now, John, before I'm gone.
Don't be silly, Grandma.
Yeah. It's only a small thing, but I need to see how
Evelyn, will you tell her to put her purse away?
Where are you off to, dear?
No, dear, where are you off to? Lavatory. Oh, I see. Beg your pardon. £2, there you are. I don't know how much it was, but there you are.
Oh, really?
Am I glad to see you?
What is that?
She's been here for ages.
Who's she?
Oh, Miss Chatterbox. I know that girl's been up to something. I don't trust her. I never did.
I must show you my shoes. What do you mean?
I know that girl's been up to something.
You mean with...
She and Paul. I know they have.
Daisy, aren't they nice?
Lovely. They have them in blue,
which is much nicer.
But then I realised I had nothing else that would have gone with them. He didn't want them round. That's how I know they're up to something.
Who?
Evelyn and John. He didn't want them round.
Paul didn't?
No.
Odd.
There was another sort with a strap across here. But then I realised they can't mean... I mean, why should he suddenly not want them round? They've been around here enough in the past, and then all of a sudden he doesn't want to see them anymore.
These tights don't really go with them, do they?
They do suit you.
Oh, yes, I'm very pleased.
I tried to get her to say something.
Evelyn?
Just now.
Oh, did she?
No, she's not saying anything. I mean, why should she? I know Paul, you see. I know he's with someone, and I'm sure it's her.
He came home, went straight upstairs, and washed his shirt through the other night.
I said, what's got into you? He said, what's wrong with me washing my shirt? I said, you've never washed anything in your life. He said, well, we'll have to start sometime. I said, lovely, why do you have to start in the middle of the night? And he had no answers at all, nothing. He has stood there dripping all over the floor.
Well, maybe.
What's she doing up there?
Well,
she's having a really good snoop around.
Oh,
I bet that's what she's up to. I've never trusted her an inch. She's got one of those really nasty little faces, hasn't she?
I'll tell you what, I'll go upstairs and keep an eye on her for you.
Oh, okay. Make sure she stays with my belongings, though. I'll see to Colin's mail, she'll be here soon.
Evelyn, what are you doing? Can I have a word with you, please?
What?
I want you to answer me something perfectly honestly. I want you to be absolutely straight with me. Will you do that, please?
What?
It's been brought to my notice that you and Paul have, well...
What?
I think you know what I'm talking about.
No.
That you and Paul have been having a love affair.
No.
Is this true?
I said no.
Oh, well, that's all right.
He did it in the back of his car the other afternoon, but I wouldn't call that a love affair.
You and Paul did?
Yeah.
And you have the nerve to come and sit in her house?
Ask me to. Anyway, she needn't worry. I'm not likely to do it again. He'd just been playing squash and he was horrible.
Don't know about it, you know.
Well, he must have told her because I didn't.
She's no fool. Put two and two together. He didn't want you to come around at all this afternoon. That's a sure sign of a guilty conscience to me.
Most probably because he doesn't like me very much.
Well, we liked you enough to.
Not after what I said to him.
But what did you say?
I said thank you very much. That was exciting as being made love to by a sack of crime cement. Would he kindly drive me home?
What a thing to say.
Well, he's horrible. Worse than my husband, John, and that's saying a lot.
Poor John. God help him being married to you.
Why?
Well, really?
Well, they all think they're experts in women. None of them are, usually, and by the time they are, they're not up to it anymore.
You speak for yourself.
I am. I've tried enough things to know.
Your husband to catch up with you one of these days.
He knows? Nothing he can do.
Why not?
Well, he relies on Paul for business, you see. And without Paul, he's in trouble. Business before pleasure, that's John's motto.
Sounds as if it's yours as well.
There's not much pleasure to be had by the place, is there?
I'm sorry. I find your attitude quite disgusting. Heartless, cruel and disgusting. All I can say is you're just a heartless little tart.
If you're interested, those shoes of yours are a lousy buy.
And what would you know about my shoes?
I bought a pair. They split at the size after 2 days and the diamonds off my feet.
I've nothing further to say to you.
Anyway, they're out of fashion.
I don't wish to listen to you any further. I'm off to find better company.
Don't for God's sake wake him up. He's been calling you 10 o'clock the afternoon. I don't think Evelyn feeds him properly.
He looks nice and chubby to me.
No, seriously. Look at his eyes and tell me that's normal.
He's asleep.
Well, you look at it when it wakes up. I mean, our Mark's never like that, nor Julie's. And she's had to wear glasses.
It's lovely to wear glasses.
Paul doesn't think so. He won't let her wear them when she's at home.
Well, I think he's a lovely baby. I was on again all the other day about adopting one.
What did he say?
No.
You track him in him.
He says to me, Marge, it's not like a dog, you know. We can't get rid of it if we don't like it. And then I say, we will like it. We will grow to like it. And then he says, well, what happens if it grows up to be a murderer? Then what do we do? They'll blame us.
It's not-
hours gone home.
Get a mighty. I said I'd give him a call. Do you mind?
No, no, go ahead.
Find myself a seat.
Find everything?
Fine.
Marge's just finding her husband.
Oh.
What's she reading, dear?
Nothing.
No, what is it?
Your happiness is keeping that man in your life happy. 12 tips by the psychiatrist.
You could have learned something from that.
Tip number one. Send him off in the morning with a smile. How many of us have don't bother to make that little extra effort? Have you ever graced the breakfast table without a comb for your hair?
Go on.
Admit, of course you have. Or not done that little extra something to take the shine from early morning nose. No wonder he escaped behind his paper.
I must read that.
Go on, live a little and give him a surprise of his life.
Yes, thank you, Evelyn.
Make yourself into his news today. You'll live with him till evening. Tip number two. Go on, pamper yourself with a full beauty treatment.
Yes, thank you, Evelyn.
What? That's lovely. I'll read it later.
Like I said, you can learn something from that.
Well, I'm not doing that for my bloody husband. He can stop it.
Well, Bobby dies.
Oh, sorry. Did I say the wrong thing?
Love.
suggestion. My experience has never stretched as far as to being with a man in the men's.
Again. Nice one, Jez. Nice one. Ready?
One, two, three.
So where's Pete then?
Ah, baffling about in the toilet. Here he is.
I'll sort out my
air. How much are you for the drinks?
Ah, don't worry, mate. It was only a fiver.
Yeah, I've got 20 kid change.
Cheers. Hey, Pete.
Hey. So what did you get up to last night here, Jez?
Oh, the usual, Kev, the usual. Picked up a bird. Hey! Hey, Pete. Take her home. Nice night. But I wake up and she's like,
Jez. What a relationship.
Jez, that's exactly it, mate. I said, woman, out now.
Funk soul brother, right about
out now.
Fox old brother.
What did you do?
Toothache. She's coming over. Look cool.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Go away. Hello.
Oh, I love you.
Honest dog.
Hi, I'm Lucy.
Right, here we go. No
mercy. Nice to meet you. Do you come down here very often?
Most weekends.
I mean, don't they embarrass you?
Well, they say I embarrass them. Well, they're not my friends.
Oh, that's a shame. I'll be your friend if you want.
Yeah, Jez.
Oh. I can't believe that Pete
actually... Hey! Good boy, Jez. Point.
Yeah, 20 quid for the other bird.
Go on. You in part by Slim Sheen. The views and events on this album are not to be taken literally. Upon purchasing this album, you've agreed not to try this at home. Anything else?
Yeah. Don't do drugs.
Slim Shady. We don't say Slim. Y'all say Shady. Slim
Shady.
Slim
Shady.
We don't say Bo. Yeah. Y'all say Selector. Bo.
Selector.
Bo.
Selector.
Hi, kids. You like violence?
Yeah.
Wanna see me stick 90 snails to each one of my eyelids? Wanna copy me and do exactly like I did? Try to see the death mess stuff worse than my life is? My brain can't wait. I'm trying to get my head straight, but I can't figure out what's been with the audience. Well, since age 12, I felt like a caged elf who say to himself in one space chasing his tail. Got ticked off and ripped Pamela Lee's lips off. Kissed him and said, I didn't know Senator was so pissed off. I'm about to pass out and crash. Fall in the grass faster than a fat man that said, damn too fast. Come and slide.
Wait a minute, that's my girl,
boy. I don't give a damn, Trey, send me to take the world going hot. My name is
what?
Okay, I'm going to attempt to drown myself. You could try this at home. You could be just like me. Put him up, put him up. Yeah, here we go now. Here we go now. I'm a fetus. I'm cancerous. When I did, when I answer this, you would find a bad with a bad rap growth of cannabis. I'm pregnant to death, but I choke you dead. I'm ready to flip my legs, get both of them through your skin.
Oh, no, no.
Take you in jail for bringing a piece of ass legally. I get the credit over running your boat. When I smoke down, I hit the trees full of sunny growth.
Oh no!
When my dad was in a hip hop, that would mean a lie. It can start more than a breath of blood. Hillary Clinton tried to slap me from your pervert. I ripped the flipping tops out, then a sherbert. My nerves hurt, late in the morning. Grab vanilla ice and ripped out the floor dress.
Oh, yeah.
Every girl I ever went out with a strong man. Follow me and do exactly what the song says. Smoke weed, take bill, rap the school, feel me. Want to drink and go behind the wheel, like I'm still legal. So I'm jumping up the ass right day. Some people only see that I'm white, ignoring skill. Cause I stand out like a green hat with no one's bell. I don't get pissed, I don't see through the mix. I'm the fucking out of white, I don't even exist. I'm getting cliche, babe, going on a way. Now I'm going up close,
my
Welcome to the Space Jam.
Space Jam.
Here's your chance. Do your dance at the Space Jam. Alright.
Without
death.
Yes, so is he. The library card is...
Exactly what happened?
Well, the students were just going into the library and taking books.
No. During the beating?
Oh, that. Oh, one moment she was standing up and the next she was lying down.
Dead.
Dead-ish. Really, Miss Perkins, I'm starting to find this morbid fascination with your daughter's death slightly disturbing. What's talking about here is your daughter's attitude, and quite frankly, I'm beginning to see where she's getting from.
Lisa didn't beat my daughter to death.
No, that was quite obvious from the day she arrived here. And I wondered then, and I wonder now, Miss Perkins, whether she might not have turned out a very good girl indeed to administer a few great beatings earlier on.
Are you completely mad?
Yes, I'm absolutely furious. In order to accommodate the funeral, we've had to cancel afternoon school on Wednesday.
This is outrageous.
Yes, it is. Or rather, it would be if it were true.
What?
I've been having you on, Miss Perkins.
Oh, thank God.
I wish you could have been able to bury that
little
madam.
Thank you. So, Louise, tell me what's on your mind.
I don't know, really. I've been feeling quite lonely recently. Like nobody wants me.
What do you think that is?
I don't know. I think it's to do with my husband. He's just not the same man I married 14 years ago.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. He's just changed. He's so different. He's so distant.
Okay. What we can do is try and find out why. I'm going to ask you some questions and you're going to answer truthfully, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. Does your husband come home late from work?
Well, yes. Yes, he does.
Does your husband work for attractive women?
Well, there are quite a few young ladies there, but none that he goes for.
Oh, so you're telling me he's gay?
No, he's not gay at all, no. He's just been so distant with me. I don't know what I've done.
Does he come home smelling of strange perfumes that you wouldn't wear?
Well, he does come home sometimes smelling quite musky, like white musk. I don't wear it, I think it's quite cheap. Oh my god, he is, isn't he?
What do you think?
He's having an affair! Oh my god!
Well, you can't blame him really, can you? Well, you're stretching on for 40 now. You're certainly no spring chicken.
Oh, what am I going to do? I love him so much. He's my life.
Well, I can only think of one solution.
What?
I'm going to have to talk to your husband.
No, you can't say anything to him. If he finds out that I've been talking to anyone about this, that'll be the end. He'll divorce me.
He doesn't have to know I'm a counsellor. You can just tell him that I'm a friend, a very good friend who just wants to get to know him a little bit
what
better.
What do you mean?
Well, we could go out for dinner. We could go to a pub. We could go to a movie. And maybe we could...
What?
Anyway, of course, we'll only be talking. We can talk about his work, his personal life.
You will make everything all right, won't you? I can trust you.
Can't make any promises. Anyway, does your husband prefer Indian or Italian?
Italian!
Does your husband like a bit of action or romance?
Action!
Strawberry or cherry?
What?
Anyway, tell your husband I'll meet him 7 o'clock sharp at a little Italian restaurant down the road. I'll be wearing a little red dress. I'll be charging normal rates up until 10. After 10, double and triple four, you know what.
What?
Anyway, Mrs. Dunford, it was very nice meeting you and I'll see you the same time next week.
We'll be right back. to? Look, we can talk it over, okay? Okay? Christ, why do you have to turn everything into a tragedy? Why can't we just work this out like rational human beings? What are you doing in there? You're mad, you are, and you simply don't care. That's what's wrong with you.
The uncaring, mad woman in there, actually it's the bathroom, is me. That other person, the guy who's yelling at me and begging me not to do anything foolish, is my husband.
Come out, Antonia, please.
I'm taking a cocktail of pills. Morgadon, Femidol, false suppositories and more. All orally.
Look, just say something.
My husband's already called an ambulance. They break down the door.
The first aid squad's on its way. They'll knock down the door, you know. Christ, this is the third time.
The thing I can't stand about emergency treatment is having a stomach pump, a damn tube down his throat and the day stater of the days, and the embarrassed looks everyone gives you, making me vague idiotic comments just to say something. And then, of course, I make you say a psychiatrist. Pardon, analyst. The pricker sits there in silence for 2 hours with a pipe in his mouth and then suddenly says, do cry, please, do cry.
Look, Antonia, just say something. Give a moan at least. Then I have an idea of what stage you're at. I'm going now and you won't see me again.
Actually, it's not the first time I've wanted to die.
Don't swallow the yellow pills. I need them for my asthma.
Another time I tried jumping out of the window. He grabbed me just when I was taking off.
Antonia, calm down, please. Look, you're right, it is my fault. I am a bastard. But I promise you, it's the last time I put you through a situation like this.
Do you think I give a damn? Can't you understand I'm simply not interested in you? In your affairs? In your stupid women?
You mean, if they'd been intelligent women, you wouldn't have minded so much? Look, we're just talking over on the floor. Calm down.
No, I don't give a damn. I'm going to jump.
No!
Yes!
I'll break your ankle.
Ow! First. And he really did break it, the idiot. A month my leg was in plaster. People asking me, have you been skiing? God, I was angry. Another time, I tried to shoot myself.
No, damn it, stop! I haven't got a license for it. Do you want to get me arrested?
The reason I wanted to die was always the same. He didn't want me anymore. He didn't love me anymore. And the tragedy erupted every time I found out about my husband's latest affair.
Oh, come on, be reasonable. With the others, it was only a sexual thing, that's all.
Oh, yes, with me it isn't even sex
anymore. But with you it's different. I've a tremendous respect for you, you know that.
You know what you can do with your respect. Yes, in this sort of situation I do get a tiny bit petty. But it's my husband's thoughtlessness that drove me up the wall. It couldn't go on like this. He hadn't made love to me in ages.
Why do you get such a kick out of dragging everything out in the public?
Oh, pisses you off, eh? At first I thought maybe he was overtired.
What, you fall out?
No, I won't, but there's a stage.
Yes, but the set ends there.
Right, if I'm a character in a play, I'm telling the story, so I step out of character, I can step out of the set. I was saying I thought maybe he was overtired, and then I found out he had an extremely active sex life with other people, naturally. And when I asked him to explain what had happened to him, why don't you want me anymore? He would find excuses.
I would find excuses?
Yes, you. Once you even tried to lay the blame in politics.
Me?
Watch out, you fool!
I'm a character in the play too, you know.
No, you're not. You're on the fourth floor. I was saying you tried to lay the blame in politics. He trotted out all the bits about the political backlash. You've got to understand. How can I make love of all that's going on in the country? The unions?
I didn't make it all up about the backlash. It's a fact. Isn't it true that after those struggles we went through, we felt a little bit frustrated, teetering on the brink? Look around you. What did you see? Cynicism.
Right. Some people get fed up with politics, dump their families and join the Hare Krishna lot. And some of them chuck the office and set up a macrobiotic restaurant. And some of them set up whorehouses for their own personal use. And it's all the fault of politics.
Look, I admit it's a silly kind of hobby, trying to set up as a sexual athlete. But with you it's different. You're the only person I can't do without. The woman I really love. The person I feel most safe with. Like my mother.
I knew it! Your mother? Thank you very much, you've promoted me. Wives are like civil servants. When they're no use anymore, they kick them upstairs and make them director of some useless public corporation. Well, I'd rather be demoted to a one-night stand, thrown on the bed and desired. Damn, I'm not interested in being a warm blanket for you, your huggy. Your mother. But don't you see what a bore you are? How you humiliate me? What am I supposed to be, an old booty thrown to the rubbish heap? Your mother. You'll see I can find them how and when I like. It's no use pitting on my ridiculous, self-satisfied smile. I'll set up a brothel for you. Yes, a brothel opposite your work. I'll walk up and down the pavement from the billboard that will have on it, now available beautiful wife of Mr. Smith, washed and scented, handsome discounts passed by the board of advertisers.
Do you know that's what I like about you? The way you always shoot at my moments of honesty, a sincere feeling. I tried to open up to you to talk.
Then why don't you talk? Talk! Explain yourself. Explain to me what's got into you. All these stories about bed, as if you didn't have a properly furnished house, and let go of this guy, I won't shoot myself.
Word of honour?
Word of honour, I won't shoot myself. I don't feel like it anymore. I've changed my mind.
Good.
It's you I'm going to shoot.
Don't you play silly tricks now?
I'm not.
Studies creatures that swarm and multiply in a drop of water. Few men even consider the possibility of life on other planets. And yet, across the gulf of space, minds immeasurably superior to ours regarded this Earth with envious eyes. And slowly and surely, they drew their plans against us.